Hi everyone, in this video, we'll show you how to create the garlic effect you see in Vampire Survivors using Unity's particle system component.
So we'll do the same thing as the Soul Eater. And for the particle system right here, we are going to set the shape to none. So the speed will be none as well. I'm gonna create a new particle material. This will be called Additive Particle. And it's just gonna be a particle standard unlit. And then what I'm gonna do is just set the rendering mode here to Additive. And then let's set a material for it. Material will be Additive Particle, right? We can scale the particle right here. There we go. And lifetime of 1. Emission of 1 as well. So now we have this little glow right here. And how do we replace the glow? We replace the glow by going to Texture Sheet Animation and then Sprites and then adding the sprite for garlic. Like this. So now it looks much better, right, in the sprite renderer. See that? So now we have this effect here, it looks a lot better than the sprite renderer that we have. We can maybe reduce the size a little bit to make it fit into the collider that we have designed for. Next thing we want to do is we want to make it glow. So by using particle effects and by using the additive material that we have created together, the effect looks a lot better, and then the benefit of doing something like that is we can do a color of a lifetime. And then we can just make it so that it kind of glows over time, you know, like that. Yeah, all done with particle system, so you don't have to touch animators and whatnot to get the effect to work. And then if you want to make the glow slower, you can increase the lifetime. The glow becomes slower, but you also have to remove the ray over time. And here we have garlic, so it's just done with a particle system, so it's a lot prettier, and yeah, it still works the same. So as you level up and you increase the area, the garlic will still increase in size as well. So it's just the same thing but done with particle effect. Okay. The other thing is that you see that the garlic only appears after a while. The reason for that is because we got to pre-warm the effect. Pre-warming basically makes it so that, so you see the effect only spawns once every 2 seconds. So you have to wait around 2 seconds for the effect to appear. But if you pre-warm it, then it's gonna appear right away. But probably the effect is a little too bright. So to rectify that, I can also reduce the start color right here. And then this will make the effect a lot dimmer. A lot more subtle, right?
During the stream, Terence missed out adding a rotation over lifetime to the garlic, which you see in the effect on Vampire Survivors. The effect also has a bluish tint, so you will want to change the start color accordingly. And there, we have our garlic effect from Vampire Survivors.